concrete floor.
This is your idea of a slick operation. Dripping DNA all over the place, kidnapping the first innocent bystander.
I got the card, didn't I? It's outside.
Jesus Christ. And who the hell's gonna drive? Because you're clearly not.
I'll be all right.
Fucking idiot. It has to be four people. There is no way you can manage the auction assistant and everyone downstairs on your own.
I'm well aware of how many people it has to be.
You have to call it off.
Do you want to tell Mr. Wu that we missed the one chance to get our hands on his fucking rice bowl? Because I don't. We have one window of opportunity and we're going to use it.
Fine. How?
Leave him to bleed. Need to make some calls and try and find a replacement in the next... Shit, in the next 30 minutes, call Danny if he doesn't pick up. Try and get hold of that, you know, Irish Pete.
What about him?
Let's put a bullet in him. I don't care.
I'm not a murderer, I don't intend to start now. Pass me diphenoxine and a couple of cable ties. Diphenoxine? What the fuck is that? Gets rid of headaches like you. Hold still, making things worse.
A couple of weird dreams, this will all be over.
Jeff. No one's picking up.
For Christ's sake! This guy's gonna have to do.
Are you serious?
Are you gonna go to the basement?
We've got no idea who he is.
After tonight, I'm not gonna see him again. What difference does it make?
The difference is this guy looks like trouble.
Well, Mr. Wu is trouble, and we've made a deal with him we can't go back on.
What do you say?
I don't care who does what,
as long as I get my cut.
You better not fuck this up.
Okay, let's get set. And what do I get in return? Don't push your luck. I'm taking his risk, so I want his share.
Fuck off!
Shut up, idiot.
I'll be worth the money.
Okay, I'll tell you what, you two split 50-50, that's the deal.
Done.
You can't do this!
It's done.
This one.
You're joking.
We'll find you something.
So what do I do next? Do I go along with this and then try and turn him in? Do I keep my mouth shut and take the money?
I think you need to tell me what we're doing here.
Nerve going already?
I'd just like to be prepared, that's all.
A very powerful Chinese clan called the Choys are here tonight to reacquire a porcelain ball that has been in the possession of their family for over 1,000 years.
Reacquire? What went wrong?
A careless business transaction.
So we're here to help them get it back?
We're here to stop them getting it back.
I presume we're not buying it.
What do you think?
Great. You know, I gave up stealing a long time ago.
To do what?
To study.
Then tonight's your lucky night.
How do you work that out?
Because the only thing studying will get you is unemployment.
Failed education is still no excuse for stealing, you know.
We're stealing from people who are prepared to spend millions on a piece of pottery when there are far more worthy causes in the world.
What on your worthy cause are you?
Tonight I am.
Yeah, I guess you could see it that way. You know, maybe you got a point about relieving some of these people of a sliver of their money.
Welcome to Hainsworth's. The second part of the auction has just begun.
Thank you.
$9.10 to my left. Thank you, sir. $9.10. 9.20. 9.20, thank you.
I see you.
9.30, again to
third
my left.
Row on the left.
9.40, do I hear 9.40? 9.40, thank you, sir. Looking for 9.50. 9.50 to my left. Do I hear 9.60? Fair warning, I'm selling. 9.50 once, 9.50 twice. sold for £950,000. This marvellous 12th century cabinet with its hidden compartment, which is
150 grand for its
time. Just try to keep your powder dry.
I'm sorry. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't spend it on a fucking sideboard. Sorry.
Why don't you try not talking at all?
So we come to what I feel must be the highlight of our sale this evening, lot 247. And to introduce it, first I'd like to pass you over to our expert, Miss Katie Tran. Katie.
What we have here is an absolutely exquisite example of late Ming Dynasty porcelain.
Downstairs now, mate. Is the ball there?
One of only three simply beautiful pieces remaining examples
of the
red
now.
Phoenix pattern Simon. Known to be in existence. Sebastian, if you would please.
Thank you very much indeed, Katie. It is a truly exceptional piece, the sale of which cannot be passed without remarking that its owner, Mr. Samuel Parr, who is far too modest to mention it himself, has agreed to donate 50% of the sale proceeds to the Chinese Art Restoration Fund.
Yeah, he can't afford it.
What did we say about not talking?
And so, we shall begin the selling. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Sebastian. And I would like to start the bidding, please, at £2 million. £2 million. Thank you, madam. £2 million I have to my left. Three I'm looking for. Do I hear three? Three at the back. Thank you, sir. Do I hear four? Four. Four to the lady. Thank you, madam. Four I'm bidding.
What the fuck are you doing?
Do I hear five?
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing?
Five. You get 20% on the sale price, don't
we? On the phone. Five I have. Do I hear six? Six I'm looking for. Six to my right. Thank you, sir.
How powerful did you say these toys are?
Do I now hear seven? Seven I have to the lady. Thank
Mate,
you,
stop
ma'am.
Bidding.
Seven. Do I hear eight? Eight I'm looking for. Eight with you, sir, to your bid. Looking for nine.
Matt, stop her.
Do I hear nine? Nine in the room?
Are not good.
Nine, I'm looking.
Price increases on a logarithmic
all around
closing
the
in on zero.
9 million to you, sir. Thank you very
the
much.
Chance is getting away with another
nine
bid.
Million.
Or less
so
than 20
do I hear 9.5? Fair warning. I'm selling.
Trust
9 million
me.
Once. 9 million twice. Sold to the gentleman on my right for £9 million. Thank you very much, sir. Congratulations.
23%.
I guess we'll never know, will we? Come on, let's get out of here. The wall doesn't turn on mathematics, you know.
Yeah, but mine does.
Well, maybe that's your problem.
Right now, you're my bloody problem.
A problem that just increased your cut by about 25%? Now that's mathematics.
All right, where to?
The basement. Jeffrey's going to call the lift from downstairs.
Okay, and then?
Then you're going to take out the security guard.
I'm sorry, I'm going to do what?
Just follow Jeffrey's instructions, darling. Just like you did when you stopped my bidding.
So what do I do? Do I play along and try and get out of this later? Or do I try and stop this little crime wave dead in its tracks? Okay, what are my options? I can warn the security guard instead of attacking him. Or I can take this lift up to a higher floor and maybe warn one of the employees. Or go up to the roof and maybe try and escape from there. No reception. Typical.
Excuse me, sir. Can you help me?
Of course, sir. Come on.